Aloha everybody, welcome to another episode of Hawaii vs. Spotlight, filmed and edited by our amazing partners, Propeller USA. We're here outside of Watanabe, Florida, and we're going to go inside to meet Monty and learn more about this awesome place. I'm your host, Kamaka Diaz. Let's go.
Hi everyone, Monty Pereira, General Manager, Watanabe, Florida, and welcome to our showroom.
So I'm really curious, what is it like being a florist? What's the day in the life of a florist?
Well, I think Watanabe Floral is a little bit unique because of our size.
Yeah, this place is big.
Yeah, it is big, and we do so many different things. So the first people in the building come in at around 4:30, 5 o'clock, and those are our drivers. And the first group of drivers deliver our mass market product. You know, so they go to Costco first because you have to be out of those stores at a certain time. But every day we're picking up freight. We bring in flowers from as many as we can locally, but the majority of the flowers are coming from abroad. They're brought in, they're immediately processed, they're put in our refrigeration so that they last longer. Our sales team will take orders, our design department will put them together, and our delivery team will take it out. And all throughout the day, there's tons of activity happening that you don't really realize when you park in the front. Yeah, you only see this, you don't see the back end. And the majority of our staff work the back end. And we made the decision back in September during the second shutdown that we're not gonna get shut down again. And in order to do that, you have to be an essential business. And to be an essential business, one way to do that is to sell food. So here's our food program. It's our fresh foods and market. We've turned this back area into that. So the produce is coming from Alun Farms. We use Kalei eggs, again, eggs from Waianae, cucumbers and tomatoes. Those are from other whole farms, again, on the North Shore. Again, we're trying to make as many local partnerships as we can, because if we're gonna survive COVID, we're gonna have to do it together. Yeah. So I think businesses that survive this are gonna come out the backside in much better shape because they've been forced to innovate. Yeah. And we're no exception.
Yeah. When I thought of Watanabe Floral, I was like, oh, flowers. And then I walk in and I see so many other things that's just not flowers. So
yeah, I mean, we've continually looked to do different things. What you don't see here that we also do is we've partnered with Hawaiian Chip Company, and we've partnered with Enjoy in a way that allows people to buy snacks on our website and it's shipped directly to them on the mainland straight from their warehouse. Yeah. Well, we're actually in our 75th year. So Mr. Watanabe was, just before he got deployed into World War II, he and Mrs. Watanabe were gonna get married.
Yeah.
But he got deployed. So while he was there, he started to grow roses outside his barracks. And he thought there's a lot of people in his shoes that once the war was done, they're gonna get married. So he wanted to have a floral business. So we were growers for the most of the first 40 years at Watanabe Floral. But we've evolved over time, and in 2008, all growing operations were shut down. It's a global economy, and most of the flowers come from Asia, South America, Mexico, outside of the country even. So we stopped growing, and now we just do all kinds of floral. We work with mass marketers. So we work with Costco, Sam's Club, Walmart, Foodland, Target, Safeway. And then we do wholesale, so other florists that are looking to resell. And then, of course, everything you see here, retail customers can have at it. I mean, every year we work with a particular nonprofit, whether it be Make-A-Wish Foundation or Ronald McDonald House. So what we normally do is we'll solicit money in the store all month long, and then we'll give a portion of our proceeds on Mother's Day Saturday back to the charity. So that we do every year. But more recently, because we couldn't do that last year because we were shut down, in the month of December, we partnered with the Laulima Giving Program. So we were collecting toys here for underprivileged kids. Me and my staff, we worked a telethon to try and generate monies for them. But no matter how hard the situation is for us or anyone else, there's always people worse off. And you always have to focus on giving back and doing the right thing for as many people as you can. Because again, the stronger the community as a whole, the better an opportunity we have as a company to make a difference.
Making the community happier, one flower at a time. So mahalo to Monty of Watanabe Floral for showing us around and telling us the history of this amazing place, bringing so much joy to this amazing community. For more episodes just like this, check us out on hawaiiverse.com. Make sure you check out their discount, 10% off. I'm your host, Kamaka Diaz. Ahui ho.